Coach CWC coming at you with another exciting review video. This time it's the Microsoft Surface Book, brought to you by DMBR Information Technologies. Visit them on the web at www.dmbrit.com. This system here is the base model. Comes with Windows 10 Pro, a 13.5-inch PixelSense display, resolution of 3000 by 2000, a 6th-gen Intel Core i5-6300U mobile processor, 8 gigs of RAM, 128 gig drive. This has the built-in Intel HD 520 graphics processor, stereo speakers, and weighs in at 3.48 pounds. Over here on the right-hand side, we've got your 3.5mm headphone jack, a mini display port, and your power. On the back is the sweet-looking fulcrum hinge that allows the device to lay properly. On the left-hand side, we've got two USB 3.0s, an SD card reader, and over here on the front is just a magnetic lip, volume rockers, and a power button. And on the front, you'll find the 5-megapixel hello recognizing camera, which you can see logged in there. Keyboard has a 1.6 millimeter travel and is excellent. As I'm typing in, the quick brown fox jumped over the fence for my buddy Aaron Baker. Now, the keyboard's got a nice layout, as you can see. They're good. No flex on the keyboard. Works really well. It's probably my top two favorite keyboards of the year. This and the Dell XPS 15, and you can check out my review up on the top. It says a 3-stage keyboard for backlighting, as you can see there. That was in the daylight. This is what it looks like if you have your lights off. So it lights up nice and bright, so it makes it very convenient to use whether it's dark or light out. This does have a nice glass trackpad, one of the best that I've used. This is probably the best trackpad out of any laptop that I've used. It has very nice small bezels around the edges. Just a beautiful, beautiful display. Great for schoolwork, work productivity, or anything else you can use. So the detached key is a physical key right here. You can see in the upper right hand corner, you hold that down till you get this detached screen and you can pull this right off. And the top part is extremely light. It is a 1.6 pound display up here on the top, and you can charge the top while it is detached from the unit with those power connectors on the bottom. As you can see there on the right hand side, you still have your 3.5 millimeter headphone jack, so you can listen to audio or play games while you have the top part taken off. And to simply put it back on, as you can see, you just slide it back onto the magnetic hinges and it does grab and say that it is attached. I do have a microSD card reader, so every time, of course, that I attach or detach the unit, it does want to look for that device. There's also a software button, as you can see, I just pushed on there to detach the device, same thing. And again, to put it back on, you just simply hold it right back into the spot and it automatically slides down to click into place. Let's get into the pen on this model. I do like the fact on the newer versions, instead of the old Surface Pro 3s, you only have one button. I didn't like the way that it felt with the two buttons because it did get in the way and there was no way to really hold the pen comfortably. So on this one, if you press once, it's going to go ahead and open up OneNote for you so you can get in there and start accessing your information right away. If you press it twice, it does what's called a screen capture. So you can then select anything that's on your screen. It doesn't matter what it is. And then it will automatically let you write on it, make any annotations that you want, copy, paste, do different things into OneNote with it. And then when you're done, you just simply tell it to save. If you do a long press and hold, it will open up Cortana and allow you to then use your voice commands with the built-in microphone. And on here, I just asked it what the weather was. It's a beautiful 51 degrees out, February 22nd, brr. Let's show you what actual workflow looks like with the pen. Our company does a lot of website design and editing. So what I like to do is if I click on this inside of Microsoft Edge, I can then just start writing right away. I can make notes. I can say, hey, I don't like this. I like this over here. What would it look like if I changed it? If I want to quickly erase it, I can use the back just like an eraser, or I can click on the eraser button. If I want, I can put in little text fields. I can type in text for notes on it. So this is a great tool for anybody who wants to annotate things that are on the web or anything really that's on your screen with a screen capture. It's an excellent ability to use. And then when you're done, you just tell it to save. It will go to your Quick Notes, your OneNote application into the Quick Notes, and it will save it there. Just wanted to show you one of the apps I use. This is the Battery Bar Pro, and it does show the battery that's on the top and the battery that's on the bottom. So the laptop portion in the keyboard battery and the top portion in the display. As you can see, this is standard Windows 10, so you do have the choice if you want to have the modern interface there, or if you like to take it away like I do, so it looks more Windows 7-ish. You do have that option, and it makes it a little easier, more comfortable for whichever way you're holding it, whether it's in laptop mode or just the stand. I wanted to show you how you can quickly increase the amount of storage you have on here, because it does have a micro SD external slot that I use this BenQI card, and I'll link that down below. I got from Amazon, and it does sit flush. It looks nice. Inside that, I do have a 200 gig drive, so that takes my system up to 328 gigs of storage just by simply inserting this micro SD card and sliding into the slot, and it does sit flush and it looks nice. Looks like it's part of the unit. Now let's go ahead and get into the gaming portion of this, just so you can see what this Intel HD 520 can do. This is Counterstrike Go, running it at 1200 by 800 resolution, everything pretty much set to low. And this does get 70 to 80 frames per second with no problem. I'm going to let you go ahead and watch some of the gameplay here and see what you think.
Throwing fire!
Oh, outside.
Throwing smoke!
Where's the casual clothesman?
Now I'm going to take you over here so you can see a little bit of a more modern game. This is Call of Duty Black Ops 3. You can see that I'm going to change the same thing. The 1280 by 800 seems to be a good resolution. I did tell it to sync every frame so you don't get any tears, things like that. And this will run a respectable 25 to 30 frames per second. It is playable. I know a lot of guys, you know, your competitive guys like to have 60 frames plus, but really, honestly, anybody at home that's playing, you can easily play with anything over 25 and above, at least I feel. So you can see here, I don't have the mouse settings or anything set up yet. I literally just turned it on, so they're really slow, so excuse some of the gameplay, but I did change it later. But I just wanted to show you what it looks like. You can run some more modern titles, and they do run pretty decently as long as you don't crank the resolution up too high. You know, I do find that 1280 by 800 seems to be a good magic number, and then just keep the resolutions, you know, your anti-aliasing, everything like that. Just turn those all down just so you can get a respectable frame rate. So I'm going to let you see a little bit more here. This is one of my favorite features of Windows 10, and it's absolutely beautiful on this 13.5-inch display, and that's connecting to your Xbox One. You can play any game that you have on your Xbox One. So you can see here that I have attached it to my system over there. It's a 55-inch LCD screen, and you can see there's zero lag. So anywhere in my house, as long as I'm connected to the same Wi-Fi network, I can play any game that I have over on that system. So let me show you what the gameplay looks like on here.
Green.
So that'll do it for my review. If you would, hit that subscribe button. If you loved it, hit the thumbs up. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them down below. I always do try to answer every question I can. And I appreciate everyone watching. Love you guys. Thank you for watching all my videos. And I will see you on the next one.